There are also lots of solar eclipse events happening here in North Carolina.
Meteorologist Dylan Hudler highlights some of those happening here in the Piedmont Triad. Take a look.
On Monday, a solar eclipse will pass across several U.S. cities. Although North Carolina is not in the path of totality, we'll still experience a partial eclipse, and places throughout the state are hosting events for you and your family to come out and see it. So starting off in the Triad, Guilford Technical Community College will have solar filtered telescopes set up, along with solar eclipse glasses available from 1:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. And next, the Surrey Community College Science Division is also hosting a viewing event from 1 to 4 in the afternoon near the library on the Dobson campus. And if you want to head up to the mountains, you can see the eclipse with a Blue Ridge view at Grandfather Mountain from 11 a.m. until 3:30 p.m. Programs are included with the park admission, and the first 100 people get free solar eclipse glasses. Now, if you can't come out in person, NASA will have a live stream set up starting at 1 p.m. You can find a link to more right now on our website, WXII12.com. I'm meteorologist Dylan Hudler.
Dylan, thank you. And folks, you can find the full list of those viewing events, plus the best times to look up, resources for proper eyewear, and more right now on WXII12.com, as well as our free mobile app. Dylan has been doing all things eclipse this week.
Yes, yeah.
Now, of course, we just got to make sure we can all see it, whatever the path of totality might be in.
So interesting.
All important forecast, Brian. Right.
Well, there looks to be some clouds and rain in that path. I think the northeast will probably have the best view of it. Locally, it looks a little iffy. We're going to go into the forecast here in a moment. But first, I kind of want to give you the details in case you've missed us talking about this for like 400 times at this point. It's worth reviewing. This happens all Monday afternoon over about a span of 2.5 hours. It will start as a partial eclipse here locally. We'll see about 85% of the sun's light obscured by the moon at its peak, but this will begin kind of on the bottom right-hand corner of the moon just before 2 p.m. So we'll be watching that approach and move over the moon. It reaches its maximum eclipse somewhere between 3:10 and 3:15. It really depends on where you live, and you can see only about 15% of the sun's light remains. The moon will continue to move and exit on the top end of this just before 4:30. So we would only hope for a perfectly blue sky like this. Unfortunately, that is not what we are looking at. As we kind of look at some of our lower resolution models, this allows us to go out further in time. We're not quite in the range of our higher res models yet to get us to Monday, but by tomorrow we will be. But this kind of gives us a broad view. A storm system begins to move across the nation right into that path and brings at least some rainfall coverage. I don't think it's going to be this extensive, but notice as we get into the Triad, this takes us into Monday morning. Clouds are on approach and we'll start to fill in. I still think we'll have breaks in the cloud cover enough where you can view the sun during the eclipse. That could change, so you need to monitor the forecast pretty well. The farthest that our higher resolution models go out is early Monday morning. You can see this is a better look at the rainfall coverage. It doesn't look terribly wet, but there will be clouds around, and we'll start to fill in over our area during the daytime. I'm still optimistic that we're looking at patchy clouds and sunshine. It's going to be a nice day otherwise, with temperatures in the lower 70s. I expect the day to be dry, but we will bring better rain chances in for Tuesday, Wednesday, and even Thursday of next week. It's